Thanks everyone for joining me today for our cardio workout. We're going to start with a dynamic warm up to get our bodies ready for our workout. I'm just going to start by walking around my space to just gently warm up. As I'm walking, I'm going to add in some arm swings, keeping my hands down at my side. I'm just going to swing my arms forward and back, loosening up my shoulders, my chest, whatever feels good to just start off with some light movement. Once you're feeling good with walking it out, I'm going to come to the center of my mat for windmill toe touches. I'm going to do about 10 of these, again, at your own speed, having my feet a little bit wider than shoulder width apart. My arms are out into that T position. Elbows are straight. Going to touch opposite hand down towards opposite foot. Taking my time on these, feeling that nice stretch in the backs of my legs, through my back, and in my hips. Got a couple more here. Loosening up our whole body with these. After you've done about 10, I'm going to stand back up, bring my feet in a little bit closer together. I'm going to keep my arms in that T position. I'm going to move into some arm circles. I'm going to do forward circles, starting with big circles and then getting a little bit smaller. Feeling that stretch in my shoulders, in my back. And then I'm going to pause and go the opposite way. Now I'm going to do circles backwards. Again, starting with bigger circles, getting smaller, really just loosening up our upper body. And then once you're feeling good with arm swings, I'm going to let my arms fall down at my side. I'm going to shake out my shoulders. I'm just going to do a couple shoulder rolls, rolling my shoulders back behind me. And then I'm also going to go forward. And once that feels good, just shaking out my arms, letting them fall down at my side. I'm going to move into high knees or marching in place. I'm going to start slow, just bringing one knee up at a time towards my chest. And I'm going to gradually increase the speed. So for about the last 15 seconds, trying to get my heart rate up a little bit, going a little bit quicker. It's good to get your heart rate up a little bit before you get into the workout so that your body's ready to go. We'll go about 10 more seconds here with this high knee or marching in place. And in 3, 2, 1. Awesome. I'm going to switch now to glute kicks. Going to put my hands on my hips, feet shoulder width apart, kicking one heel at a time back towards my glutes, feeling that stretch in your quads at the tops of your legs. Again, going to start slow and I'm going to pick up the pace a little bit. Trying to get my heart rate up. We'll go about 15 more seconds here with these glute kicks. Awesome. And 3, 2, 1. Last little warm-up exercise. Gonna go about 20 seconds here, just jogging in place, moving your feet up and down off the ground as quick as you want. Just again, getting our heart rate up, loosening up our full body. 10 more seconds here, just jogging in place. Awesome. And 3, 2, 1, and take a deep breath. We're going to move in to our first sequence of the day. We do have a new workout plan for December, and I'm going to take a quick sip of water. Our first sequence, we have two exercises. Each exercise we're going to do twice for 30 seconds each. Each exercise will be followed by active recovery. Active recovery is totally up to you how you want to move your body, depending on what your goals are for the workout. I'm going to call out an active recovery that's basically just moving our feet. So the goal is to slow our heart rate down, but keep our feet moving for as long as we can. Anytime you need to take a break, grab some water, please do so. The first exercise for sequence number one, we have a side jack or a step jack. So all this is half of a jumping jack. I'm going to start with my right side. I'm going to step my right foot out one step to the right. As I am stepping that right foot out one step to the right, I am also raising my right hand, fingertips to the ceiling, elbow is straight. I'm going to bring both my right foot and my right hand back to my side. And then I'm going to repeat on the left side. So stepping out my left foot, one step to the left, raising that left hand up in the air. And I'm just going to alternate from side to side with this side jack or a step jack. Modifications for this one, you can take this into a jumping jack if you want to add the impact, moving both legs and both arms at the same time, and then adding that jump in with your feet as you step them both out. Or you can keep it as a step jack or a side jack, depending on what your goals are for today. Any questions with the step jack or side jack? Awesome. And then the second exercise for sequence number one is a shuffle step crunch. So a two-part movement here. We're gonna start just with that shuffle step, taking two steps to the right. My right foot will be leading. After I take two steps to the right, I'm going to do a high knee core twist, so a crunch in front of my body, bringing my left knee and right elbow together in front of my body. So I'm getting that core crunch at the center, kind of by my belly button. After I do that crunch, I'm lowering that left foot down, lowering my right hand down, and I'm gonna do the same thing now going to the left. So my left foot is leading. I'm taking two steps of that side shuffle. After two steps, bringing my right knee and my left elbow together in front of my core, doing that little core twist, putting your foot down, and then alternating. Options for this one, if you have more space than just two steps and you want to take three or four steps to get a little bit more cardio in and movement, you can definitely do that. If you want to take the steps out altogether and just do alternating core twists in front of your body, that's also an option as well. Any questions with shuffle step crunch? All right, those are our two exercises for sequence number one. We are going to start at the beginning with side jacks. This sequence number one, we're gonna go through three times, starting in about 10 seconds with side jacks in 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Side jacks, raising that right arm and stepping out your right leg at the same time, and then alternating to that left side. Ten seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. I'm gonna jog in place. Active recovery, you choose whatever movement feels good for you. We are on to that second round of side jacks in 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Going at your own speed for these as well. You can slow it down or you can pick up the intensity. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna glute kick. We're on to the second set of exercises here with our shuffle step crunch. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, shuffle step crunch, taking two steps, and then opposite knee to opposite elbow. Halfway. Less than 10. And And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna march in place. Way to keep your feet moving during this active recovery. Second round, shuffle step crunch. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Keeping that core engaged as you're doing that crunch. Belly button in towards your spine. Halfway. Five seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. I'm gonna sidestep. One step left, one step right. We are back to the beginning. That was our first time through. Doing that same thing, starting with side jacks. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, round number 2. Halfway. Got that Bob Barker suit game and Plinko in my style. Money, stay on my craft and stick around for those pounds. But I last 10 seconds. The torch and put on for my town. Trust me, on my INDEPEND. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm going to walk it out. Walk or jog. Taking some deep breaths during this active recovery, trying to slow your heart rate down. Second round of side jack in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Halfway. Five seconds. 3, 2, 1, and active recovery. I am going to sidestep. Y'all can't stop me. Go hard like I got an 808 in my heartbeat. And I'm eating at the beat like it gave a little speed to a great white shark on shark. We rock. Time to go up. Second round of exercises here. Double step crunch. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Sing this song and it goes like. Raise those hands, this is our party. We came here to live life like nobody was watching. I got my city right behind me. If I fall, they got me. Learn from that failure, gain humility. Halfway. And we keep marching. Can we go back? This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. Less than 10. Put our hands up like the ceiling can hold us. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna do calf raises. Raising up onto my toes, lowering down to my heels, strengthening those ankles, calves, and getting a little recovery. Second round, shuffle step crunch. 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Halfway. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna jog in place. We are back to the beginning. One last round through from the top. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, last round. Side jack. Halfway. Five seconds. 3, two, one. Active recovery. I'm going to sidestep.
Oh, my fan's going on high.
What'd you say?
I said my fan's going on high.
Oh, yes. Starting last round, side jacks in three, two, one. Go ahead. Last 30. Ten seconds. And in three, two, one. Active recovery. I'm gonna march in place. Last two rounds of exercise to finish up sequence number one. Starting in three, two, one, go ahead, shuffle step, crunch. Halfway. Last 5 seconds. Three, two, one, active recovery. I'm gonna jog it out. Last active recovery. Less than a minute here. Way to keep your body moving this whole sequence. We got last 30 seconds in three, two, one. Go ahead, shuffle step crunch. Last 15. Five seconds. Three, two, one, and recover. Whew. Nice work, everyone.
That was a good workout.
I know, I am sweating already. Sequence number one. Nice job. Grab some water, catch your breath. We are gonna move to sequence number two. Again, we'll go through this one three times, starting at the top with our first exercise, a step back, kick forward. So another two-part movement. We're gonna start with our feet shoulder width apart. Make sure you have enough space behind you and in front of you for a little bit of movement on this one. We're gonna start the first 30 seconds with just our right leg. So I'm gonna start by stepping my right foot back one step, just planting my toes firmly on the ground. I'm keeping my heel in the air. And then after that step back, I'm going to immediately kick that right leg forward out in front of me. So a step back and a kick forward. After you extend your leg in front of your body, kicking forward, I'm gonna lower that right foot down and then go again. So step back, kick forward for the entire 30 seconds. Any questions with that?
So it's just constantly stepping and kicking. I don't have to go step, kick down with the same foot, right? Just keep stepping back and forth?
Yep, just keep stepping and kicking. Right after the kick, I put my foot right back into that step back position.
Yeah, that's what I was going. Because if I step right down in front, it's gonna be like take more time. So
yeah, whatever works best. Just trying to get that lower body movement and then kicking intentionally, like there's something in front of you.
Okay.
Yep. And then second 30 seconds, we'll do the same thing on the left leg.
Ashley?
Yeah.
Is it more like a kick from the knee or a straight out kick like a Frankenstein to get our hamstrings?
I'm doing it more a kick from my knee. So like a kickboxing,
okay.
Bending my knee and then straightening it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Oh, got it. No hands, right?
My hands are just staying in front of my chest in like loose fists, but wherever your hands are comfortable, you can have them on your hips. Doesn't really matter.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks.
Yeah. And then the second exercise is a sidestep with an arm raise. So I'm going to start this one with my feet just shoulder width apart, and I'm going to start with my hands in the air. So fingertips to the ceiling, my elbows are straight. I'm going to start by just stepping my right foot one step to the right. As I step that right foot, I'm going to lower my right hand down to my side while keeping my left hand kind of up in the air where it is. I'm sidestepping to the right, and then my left foot comes in to meet my right. And then as I step that left foot one step to the left, I'm bringing that right arm back up. And then as my right foot comes in to meet my left, lowering my left hand down. So it's a sidestep with an arm raise, but every time you step, you're lowering the arm down at your side with the foot that you're stepping with.
Okay.
So it sounds a little confusing, but as you get into the movement, it makes a little bit more sense. Step and then lower that arm down to the ground. And we're just going to alternate from left to right.
When I step out, both hands are up, correct?
I'm starting, yep, feet shoulder width apart. Both my hands are up.
I got it.
And so then as you step your right, lower the right. And then as you step the left, lower your left hand.
Got it. Thank you. Okay.
Yeah. Any other questions? Those are our two exercises for sequence number two. Starting at the beginning with step back and kick forward in 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Focusing on that right leg for the first 30 seconds. Going at your own speed, we are halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna jog in place. Next time through, we are stepping back, kick forward with our left leg. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead, left leg. Nice job, halfway. Closer, 10 seconds, losing my balance. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna shuffle step. Next up, sidestep arm raise. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna do glute kicks. Second round, sidestep arm raise. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Lowering that same hand that you step with, keeping your core engaged. We got 10 seconds. And And in 3, 2, 1, after recovery, I'm gonna walk it out. We are back to the beginning. Another round through. Starting at the top with step back, kick forward in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead on that right leg. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. I'm gonna sidestep. Next up, same thing, this time on our left leg. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. I know you won't be there. Every time I turn around, you disappear. Taking your time here, especially if you're losing your balance a little bit like me. Doesn't have to be too quick. I wanna blow your mind. Just come with 10 seconds. Me, I swear I'm gonna take you somewhere warm, you know, j'adore la mer. And in 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. I'm gonna march in place. Second round. Sidestep, arm raised. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Tattooed on my arm in ink, I swear. Nice work here, halfway. Comes, I know you won't be there. Every time I turn around, you dare. 10 seconds. And in 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. I'm gonna walk it out. Taking some deep breaths. Letting your body recover. We got that one more time. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Sidestep, arm raise. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. I'm gonna jog in place. We are back to the beginning. One last round through for sequence number 2. Check in with how you're feeling. Our last sequence that we'll do 3 times. Starting from the top in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, step back, kick forward. Right leg.
Actually, are you pointing your toes or flexing?
Pointing.
Okay, that's what I was doing. Thank you.
I think okay. I switch it up.
Okay.
And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna walk it out. Take those legs out. Last round here on our left leg. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Last 30 seconds of this exercise. Halfway, last 15. Five seconds. 3, 2, One, active recovery. I'm gonna sidestep. Two last rounds to finish up sequence number two. Starting in three, two, one, go ahead, sidestep, arm raise. Halfway. Less than 10. And in three, two, one, active recovery. Last 20 seconds. Gonna jog it out here. One last round. Sidestep, arm raise. In three, two, one, go ahead. Last 30. Halfway. Less than 10. And in three, two, one, and recover. Whew. Nice job. Right. Let's do heart rate check.
Yeah, I was just gonna say.
Time. Time for 6 seconds here, starting in three, two, one. And in three, two, one, finish.
This is what I love.
Woo! How's everybody feeling?
Good.
Good.
I am sweating. Grab some water. Let's move on to sequence number three. All right, a little bit more of a leg and core burner on this one. First exercise we're going to do is a step out to a bodyweight squat. So starting with our feet just shoulder width apart, I'm gonna step my right foot out one step to the right. Gonna keep my feet spread a little bit further apart here. Once I take that step, I'm gonna go right into a bodyweight squat. Sitting down like I'm sitting into a chair, sticking my butt back, making sure my knees are not coming over my toes and my chest is staying forward, facing the wall in front of me. Just doing one bodyweight squat, standing back up. After the squat, gonna bring that right foot in to meet my left, and then do the same thing on the left side, stepping out my left foot one step until my feet are in a good position to do that bodyweight squat. Again, squatting down, standing back up, and then returning. A couple different ways to do this one and some modifications. If your goal is to burn out your leg muscles, take this one slow and steady. You can hold that squat at the bottom and then slowly stand back up. If your goal today is a little bit more cardio, you can take this one a little quicker and you don't have to get all the way down into that full body weight squat. You could just do a dip, which is a slight knee bend, and then back to the center. So depending on your goals, there are definitely different ways to do it. You can mix it up. But does anyone have any questions? Easy peasy. Next one we have is an alternating elbow to knee or alternating knee to elbow. So I'm going to start this one with both of my hands behind my head. Again, not grabbing on, just that's where they are so that my elbows are bent in either direction. From here, I'm going to make sure I'm standing up nice and tall, feet are shoulder width apart. I'm just going to be alternating, bringing opposite knee to opposite elbow, staying stationary, only raising one leg at a time, and keeping my hands where they are the entire time. So starting with my right elbow to left knee, left elbow to right knee, I'm just alternating back and forth, keeping that core engaged. Modification for this one, you can take your hands away from your head and just do high knees marching and then tap alternating hand to alternating knee instead of doing that whole upper body crunch, you can make it a little less impact and a little less spine twisty. Any questions? Let's do it. Two times through for this one, starting at the top. Once I pull my timer up, 10 seconds. We are starting with the step out to squat. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Step out to squat. Again, taking this one slow and steady, or you can pick up the pace. 10 seconds. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna jog. Second round here, step out to squat in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery, shake your legs out. I'm gonna march in place. Second set of exercises here. Bringing that alternating knee to elbow in 3, 2, 1, go ahead. Getting that elbow and knee as close as you can. Feeling that crunch in your core. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1. Ooh, active recovery. I'm gonna walk it out. Catch my breath. Do what you need to recover. Second round, starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, alternating knee to elbow. Halfway. 10 seconds. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna sidestep. Taking some deep breaths. We are back to the beginning. Last time through for sequence number 3. Starting at the top. In 3, 2, 1, go ahead, step out to squat. As you get tired, keeping that squat form, you're going all the way down. Super important, take your time. 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. I'm gonna walk it out. Nice work, everyone. Last round of step out to squat. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, last 30. Halfway. In my mind, I'm riding around a cold and empty space. 10 seconds. Just put your arms around me, tell me everything's okay. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna sidestep. Two rounds of exercise to finish out sequence number 3. Starting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, alternating knee to elbow. Halfway. Five seconds. And 3, 2, 1. Active recovery. Last 20 seconds. Jogging it out. Way to keep moving here. Last 30 seconds. Final round. Alternating knee to elbow. In 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Halfway, last 15. Five seconds. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Awesome job, everyone. 3 sequences down. Grab some water. Take a rest. All right, we have just under 15 minutes of our workout left. One more sequence, so we're doing great on timing today. Starting sequence number 4, final 2 exercises. First exercise we have is a V-step with punches. So if you're familiar with the V-step that we did last week's workout, I'm going to start with my feet together and making sure that there's some room in front of me. With our lower body, we're just going to be doing that V step. So I'm stepping my right foot one step in front of me, but also out to the right, and then stepping my left foot one step in front of me, but out to the left. And then to get back, I'm going to step my right foot one step back to the starting point, and then my left foot one step back to the starting point. So you're stepping in a V formation. And then we're gonna add in an upper body movement with some punches. So as you step forward, I'm doing 2 punches forward. My hands are in loosed fists, just at my chest, punching 2 punches forward. And then as I step back, returning my arms to the starting point. So the punches don't really matter which ones are most comfortable for you to use. We're just focusing on that arm movement and having strong punches forward to get in a little bit of an arm burn along with our legs. We're just gonna alternate through that for 30 seconds. Any questions with that one?
So when the arms come back, are they coming back into like a bent fist or down to the sides?
I'm keeping my hands in fists at like my chest level, my elbows bent. So that's my starting point. After I punch them forward, I'm just returning them to right in front of my chest.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Yep. All right. Then the last exercise we have is a walking press up. So 2-part movement. Our lower body is going to be just walking in place, jogging in place, whatever, again, your goals are. But we're just lifting our feet up and putting them back down. And then with our hands, we're going to be doing a press up. So I'm going to start with my elbows bent and then my palms facing the ceiling open-handed. And then as I'm walking in place, I'm just raising both of my hands up towards the ceiling, holding it for a second or two, and then lowering them back down. This is also a good one if you use weights. You can put weights in your hands to get a shoulder press, but body weight is also fine. Focusing on moving those arms with a little bit of resistance as you're pushing up. Any questions with that one?
So is it every step up and down, or is it like walk up in the air two steps, then down two steps. It'd be like so, that. Would...
I'm basically doing this as two separate movements. I start walking in place first, and I'm not really thinking about my steps. I'm just moving my arms whenever it feels good for me. Does that make sense?
Yes, yes. Okay.
Yeah, not really any coordination specific with this one. Just whenever it feels good to raise those hands up, as long as you're keeping your lower body moving consistently.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah. All right. Let's finish it out here. Last sequence of the day, starting at the top with V step and punches in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Better than birds of a feather, you and me. We change the weather. Focusing on those punches, having resistance as you move your arms forward. I've been dancing on top of cars and stumbling out of bars. I follow you 10 seconds. I can't get enough. You're the medicine and the pain, the tattoo inside my brain. And maybe you and in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna shuffle step. And in 3, 2, 1, second round, V step and punch it. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna do glute kicks. I'm a sucker for you. Moving on to our next set of exercise, walking press ups in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Keeping those feet moving, any speed that feels good. We are halfway. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna sidestep. Second round of walking, press up in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. Halfway. Less than 10. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna walk it out. I'm gonna fix my mat a little bit. We are back to the beginning. Last time through, last sequence of the day. Let's finish out strong here. Starting V-step and punches. 3, 2, 1, go ahead. I was thinking I could fly to your hotel tonight. Cause I can't get you off my mind. Can't get halfway. You off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. Less than 10. I can't seem to get you. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna shuffle step. Way to keep your feet moving. Last 30 seconds of V-step punches in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. I'm about to leave. Do you got plans tonight? I'ma
couple hundred miles from Japan, and I was thinking I could fly to your hotel tonight.
Halfway. Last 15.
Can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind.
And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna jog it out. Last 30 seconds, V step and punch in 3, 2, 1. Did we do that one twice already? Sorry, walking in place, press up. Thanks, Crystal.
Sorry.
Sometimes I forget. It's okay. 10 seconds. And in 3, 2, 1, active recovery. I'm gonna sidestep. We have one last round of exercise here. Starting in 3, 2, 1, go ahead. 30 seconds, walking, press up. To finish us out for the day. Nice job here. Last 15 seconds. Hey, 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Okay. And recover. Awesome job. We'll do a final heart rate check when you're ready. Timing 6 seconds in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. And 3, 2, 1, finish. Woo! Awesome job, everyone. We are going to move into a cool down for the last 4 minutes of our workout today. Grab some water. Take some deep breaths. I'm going to grab a little water. Let's start with a little full body stretch here and some deep breathing. Slow our heart rates down, cool down. I'm going to start with my legs a little bit wider than shoulder width apart, reaching up both hands towards the ceiling, taking in a big inhale breath, really reaching as tall as you can, feeling your spine stretch towards the ceiling. And then exhale, hands are coming down towards your toes, trying to touch your toes or the ground or as far as you can go. I'm gonna do this 3 times, going at your own speed, just really focusing on taking those deep breaths. And then exhale, coming forward, feeling that stretch in your lower body. Last one. And then exhale. On that last exhale, as your hands come down towards the ground, take a moment to just pause at the bottom. Let your body hang, feel the stretch. And then when you're ready, just very slowly stand back up, taking your time, feeling your spine uncurve. And then once you're standing back up straight, bringing those feet in together, letting your hands fall down at your side. Let's do a little arm stretch here. Worked our shoulders a lot today. I'm gonna take my right hand, bring it across my chest, fingertips point to the wall to my left, with my left hand grabbing at my right elbow and just gently pulling in towards my chest, feeling that stretch the outside of my right arm, my right shoulder. Hold here for a few seconds. And I'm gonna switch, let my arm shake out, hang, and then bring that left arm across my chest, fingertips pointing now to the right, with my right hand grabbing in at my elbow and pulling in towards my body. And when you're feeling good with that, let your arms fall down at your side, shake out your hands, and relax. Gonna finish up here with a little bit of a hip stretch and a lower back stretch. I'm gonna keep my feet a little bit wider than shoulder width apart. Gonna put my hands on my hips. I'm gonna just gently press my hips forward, lean back slightly until I'm feeling that stretch in my lower back. Hold it there for a few seconds. And then I'm gonna come back up to standing. And then just do it again at your own speed, feeling that stretch. And then to finish out here, last minute, I think, I'm just gonna come into a forward fold. So my feet are together, raising both my hands up towards the ceiling, and then reaching my hands down towards my feet, stretching out the opposite way this time from that hip forward. Now we're bending forward, stretching that lower back, backs of our legs. And when you're ready, slowly standing back up, stretch throughout the day if you have something that's bothering you. Drink a lot of water. And thank you for joining me for our cardio workout today. We will see you all next time.
Thanks, Ashley.
You're welcome.